We're back at Pro Wrestling Illustrated Scouting Reports, and Rick, we're going to have an interview with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
You know, you amaze me. You still insist upon talking upon a has-been, a man who is not competing in our sport right now, a man who may never compete in professional athletics, period, again, much less professional wrestling.
Well, just...
What's this deal you got for Dusty Rhodes? He's done. He's not competing at present time. Why waste important time in our program to talk about a man like Dusty Rhodes, who's finished? He's a has-been.
Well, you probably think that we have a videotape of Dusty Rhodes. However, we're now going to go live to Dusty Rhodes' home and speak with him. Hello, American Dream.
Bill, I'm just real good to see you and talk to you here live from my home. I got two statements to make, two things to say, and I'll get off this program that is your program, Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. You're talking to Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, because for the last 10 years, he has dominated the sport of professional wrestling. You're talking to him because you, as a sports writer and a builder of magazines, the greatest wrestling magazines in the world, for the last 10 years, no man has graced the cover of your magazine more than Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. Not because we're friends, it's because Dusty Rhodes sells more magazines. No promoter has called Dusty Rhodes and just wanted him because he was a friend. They called Dusty Rhodes because he is the greatest single box office attraction in this country today. And now we're sitting here talking about my injury and everything. Let me tell you something. This big old boy from Austin, Texas, the son of a plumber, you know, my old man was a plumber and all he knew was plumbing. He was the best at what he did. Well, Dusty Rhodes is the best at what he did. Bar none. And for 3 or 4 weeks that have went by, I have taken an oath of silence and have not speak. And I want to apologize to my many fans because that's not the way I am. The mental agony, the mental strain, the mental anguish that I went through is over now. I've got that out of my mind. My thing now is coming back, working my way back, getting myself back ready for what I got to do. And I'm telling you what, I might have 1,000 great matches left in me, Bill Apter. Or I might have
You got something
one.
To say to me. Forget about Bill Apter. You got something to say to me.
I might have that one super match. And that one there, baby, is what Dusty Rhodes coming back for. And sitting here with Ric Flair, it doesn't bother me at all because I know me sitting here and him sitting there, the cheap shot artist that you are, kid, you can't jump through the screen and get me from where you're at right now.
Dusty, the one question that the fans want to know is, will you ever be able to wrestle again?
Just like I said.
Yeah, let's hear this up front. Why don't you address this to me, Dusty Rhodes? I'm the host of this program. If you got something to say, say it to me. Forget about Bill Apter.
Well, you know, in years past, Ric Flair would have said it to you, but after losing the amount of respect that I have for you and the amount of respect that the people across this country have for you as an athlete and anything else, it doesn't really matter. I'll address this to you and I'll tell you one time. Just like everybody has a cutoff date in this life, brother, I am the American Dream. I live the American Dream, Ric Flair. From day one, I don't have to wear the Ralph Lauren suits and wear the Rolex watches and pretend that I'm somebody that I ain't. And that's all you're doing is pretending. Now, I used to really believe in you, kid, but now you're pretending. So I'm going to give you something to pretend about. Pretend that I'm not coming back. But mark it down in your book, brother, I'm on a time schedule. And Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, is coming back 100%. And this is just a little bit different. All the ha-ha and the glamour and all the wristwatches and all the suits you wear cannot save you now from Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. So you can talk all you want here about Dusty Rhodes. That's what I'm talking about, kid.
I'm going to tell you right now, it's a medical impossibility. And I've taken pride in the fact that it's a medical impossibility for you to ever perform the level you used to perform at, if perform at all is advised in a professional wrestling ring. You're done. My hands are washed of you and your claim to the World Heavyweight Championship.
Let me say this one thing, Flair. My hands are clean of this situation. I heard one man that night that stuck in my craw more than anything in the world, standing at ringside when they canned me out. And he said, Dusty Rhodes, you're too good. You're too nice. You got what you deserve, baby. Well, that's fine. That stuck right in my craw. I got what I deserve. Let me tell you something, Ric Flair. And you put this down, and you think about it, and you remember this. Ric Flair, I have no respect for you as a world champion. I have no respect for you as an athlete. I have no respect for you as a human being. You are a farce. You are a phony. You are a has-been.
You are not. You are a pretender in a great athletic sport that you're in. And Dusty Rhodes tells that
nobody's going to talk to me like this on my program.
You're a pretender.
I don't care what you got to say to the world, Dusty Rhodes. You keep in mind that I put you where you're sitting right now with your leg on that table, all wrapped up
We're
in a big white cast.
We'll see you on scouting reports next week.
The world champion.